dear art lovers, I'm glad to meet you here. In this video, I will tell you how professional artists sharpen their pencils and why better to do it this way. First of all, caution. You have to be very careful because the knife is very sharp and this can be a little dangerous. I'm not responsible for any damage you may cause using this technique. Often, in offline lessons that I teach, students ask me to show how to sharpen a pencil. And that the first time there are some difficulties, and I will tell you what you need to pay attention to make it easily and successfully. You hold the pencil firmly in your supporting hand and the knife in other hand. You place the knife blade on the pencil, start pushing it with your thumb and remove away the woody parts and get the lead to be exposed. With the hand that holds the knife, you make almost no effort. You just put it on the pencil and you do most of the movements with your thumb. If you press hard and make movements with the knife, then you can break the pencil lead, especially when it gets longer. Also, to keep the lead long, you need to remove the wood in small pieces. Don't try to do it faster. Use as meditation. Art is very meditative activity and it starts with the very first and smallest actions, such as the preparation of the tools and pencil sharpening. Take a deep breath. Keep sharpening. Exhale. Keep sharpening. Gently and lightly. By the way, I'm Sarah, an artist, author, and presenter of a drawing course for beginners, which I'm recording right now and will gradually publish. If you want to see more videos, please subscribe. Once you have freed and exposed the desired length of the lead from the wood, you can proceed to sand the tip of the lead itself. This can be done with light sliding movements with the knife. Wood shavings can be removed, so that in the future it would be easy to collect lead dust. You can also use sandpaper to sand the lead. Save the dust in a box and use it in your drawings. It is useful to make different textures and smooth transitions of tone. You can do it with a cotton swab or a brush. In one of my next videos, I will show you how you can use it for drawing. A beginner in painting and drawing usually is not so selective in how a pencil is sharpened. And for professionals, this has a really great importance. Now I will tell you why. The main reason: line variability. When using a regular sharpener, only a small part of the lead is released and takes the shape of a short cone. So it is very difficult to make the line quite diverse. The long lead allows you to make lines of different thickness and intensity. The line turns out to be lively, dramatic, and contrasting. The tip of the lead can be thin and sharp as a needle, or it can be in the shape of a scapula, which allows you to make wide hatching. Thus, when sharpening with a knife, you can form the length, thickness, and plane of the lead for your artistic goals and for sketches or detailed studies. Second, you can draw for a long time. When drawing with a pencil sharpened with a sharpener, it becomes short very quickly and you need to sharpen it again and again and again. This distracts and prevents you from concentrating and completely immersing yourself in the creative process. And if you sharpen the pencil as a professional, make a lid long, so during the drawing you gradually can turn the pencil in your hand, then the lid will be sharpened on its own if you work correctly. In addition to all these reasons, there is another one that you must have noticed, that sometimes the lid can break inside the sharpener. This is because the blade is sometimes set at the wrong angle. Then you can simply finish the entire pencil by grinding it off completely using a faulty sharpener that will constantly break it. So we see that sharpening a pencil in such a way as we have studied above is much better and more useful in all causes. At the same time, colored pencils should still be sharpened with a sharpener because the lid of a colored pencil is usually very soft, and if you make it very long, it becomes too fragile. But the sharpener must be chosen correctly. About this and about colored pencils, we will talk in other videos. Great! We are gradually came to the finish. I sincerely thank you for your attention. Feel free to tell me in the comments how was this video useful for you and what else you would like to know. If you feel that this video is useful for you, you can like and share it. Don't wait and subscribe to my channel and get more useful art videos. See you soon in the space of art.